everybody! Welcome to Kids Workshop. I'm Ellie Ray. Have you ever been thirsty? I mean, really, really thirsty? There's only one thing that can help. Water. Today we're going to hear from Tristan Peters about when Jesus told the woman at the well about the living water. But first, let's stand up and sing to Jesus.
Death could not hold you. The veil tore before you. You silenced the boast of sin and grave. The heavens are roaring, the praise of your glory. For you are raised to life again. You have no rival. You have
Jesus had been teaching in Judea. He and his disciples began traveling back to Galilee. They traveled through Samaria and stopped in a town with a well. Jesus' disciples went into town to buy food. While Jesus was at the well, a Samaritan woman came to get water from the well. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." The woman was surprised. "Why are you talking to me?" she asked. "You are a Jew and I'm a Samaritan." Jesus said, "I asked you for a drink. You don't know who I am. If you did, you would have asked me for a drink, and I would give you living water." The woman was confused. She said, "Sir, this well is deep and you don't have a bucket. Where do you get this living water?" Jesus said, "Anyone who drinks this well water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks from the water I give will never be thirsty again. In fact, the water I give will become a well inside you, and you will have eternal life." Jesus was talking about the Holy Spirit, but the woman did not understand. "Sir," she said, "give me this water. If I'm not thirsty, I won't have to keep coming to this well to get water." "Go get your husband," Jesus said. "I don't have a husband," the woman replied. Jesus knew she was telling the truth. He said, "You don't have a husband now, but you've had five husbands." "Jesus was right. I see you are a prophet," the woman said. "Maybe this prophet could explain something to her," she said. "The Samaritans worship here on a mountain, but the Jews say we need to worship at the temple in Jerusalem." Jesus said, "Soon you will not need to be in either of those places to worship God in spirit and in truth." The woman said, I know the Messiah is coming. When he comes, he will explain everything to us. Then Jesus said, I am the Messiah. The woman left and told the people in her town, come see a man who told me everything I ever did. Could this be the Messiah? Many Samaritans believed in Jesus because of what the woman said. Jesus stayed in their town for 2 days. Many more believed because of what Jesus said. They told the woman, we no longer believe because of what you said, for we have heard for ourselves and know that this really is the Savior of the world. Jesus offers something better than physical water. He gives us himself. Jesus gives the Holy Spirit to everyone who comes to him by faith. We can worship him as Lord and Savior wherever we are.
Hi everyone, thank you for joining us today. If you can, go ahead and grab your Bible, and we are going to be reading in the book of John, chapter 4, and we're going to start at verse 1. Today we're going to learn about when Jesus talked to the Samaritan woman and showed kindness to her. So Jesus and his disciples had been in Judea, and they are on their way to Galilee. But in the midst of traveling from Judea to Galilee, they decide to stop in Samaria. And so when they get to Samaria, Jesus sends his disciples into the town to get some food, and he goes to a well to sit down and wait. And while he was at the well, a Samaritan woman came up to get her water. And it was very unusual that someone went to get their water in the middle of the day, because that was the hottest part of the day. Most people got their water in the morning or in the evening. But she came in the middle of the day, and she was so surprised to see Jesus there, because Jesus was a Jew and she was a Samaritan, and the Jews and the Samaritans did not get along very well. Jesus asked her, "Can you get me something to drink from the well?" And she was surprised that Jesus was talking to her, because the Jews and the Samaritans did not get along. And Jesus said, "If you knew who I was, you would be asking me for a drink of water, and I would give you living water." The Samaritan woman had no idea what living water was. She was confused. But she said, "Sir, you don't even have a bucket, and the well is so deep. How are you going to get water out of the well without a bucket?" But Jesus said, "Everyone who drinks from the water will be thirsty again. But anyone who drinks from the water that I give will never be thirsty again. In fact, the water I give will become a well inside of you, springing up with eternal life." Jesus was talking about the Holy Spirit, but the Samaritan woman did not understand. She said, "Sir, please give me some of this living water, because if I have some of this living water, I will not have to come to this well again and draw out water every single day." Jesus said to her, "Go and call your husband and bring him back here." She said, "I don't have a husband." Now Jesus knew the truth. He said, "You are correct. You don't have a husband right now, but you used to have 5 husbands." The woman said, "I can see that you are a prophet. Can I ask you a question?" And she asked Jesus, "The Samaritans worship here on the mountain, and the Jews worship in the temple. Which one is correct?" And Jesus said, "Soon there will be a day where you don't have to be in either place to worship God in spirit and in truth. But an hour is coming when anyone can worship at any time. The Father wants everyone to worship him in spirit and in truth." And the woman said, "I know that the Messiah is coming." And Jesus looked at her and said, "I am the Messiah." The woman was so surprised, she jumped up and she ran as fast as she could back to the city. And she started telling everyone she knew, come and see the man who can tell me everything that I've ever done. Come and see the Messiah." The woman's life was changed because of her encounter with Jesus. And everyone that she told, come and see the Messiah, came and followed her. And so many people came and listened to Jesus, and their lives were changed because of the Samaritan woman's testimony. When our lives are changed, when we have an encounter with Jesus, Jesus gives us living water, which is better than anything here on earth. He gives us the gift of eternal life in the Holy Spirit. That is so much better than doing well at school or money or a job or video games. Jesus gives us so much more. The eternal things are much more important than the worldly things. But when Jesus shows us kindness like he did to the Samaritan woman, and when we have an encounter with Jesus and he changes our lives, we should not keep it inside. We should not keep it a secret. We should be like the Samaritan woman who was so excited that she had to tell everyone she knew, because then more people can come to know Jesus, just like they did because of the Samaritan woman's testimony. And so, before we leave, I have two challenges that I want to send home with you. First of all, do you think you can do these challenges? You totally can. I believe in you. First challenge, I want you to show kindness to someone, just like Jesus showed kindness to the Samaritan woman. Although the Jews and the Samaritans did not get along, that didn't stop Jesus. He showed her kindness and it changed her life. So, first challenge is to show kindness to someone this week. Your second challenge is, if you don't have a relationship with Jesus, if you don't know that Jesus is the Messiah, and if you have not accepted his gift of living water and eternal life, I want you to ask somebody a question about what it means to follow Jesus. Jesus has changed my life. Maybe Jesus has changed your life. And I can't wait to see what all Jesus does in your lives as he uses you to further his kingdom. And so those are my challenges to leave with you this week. Show kindness to someone and ask a question if you don't know what it means to follow Jesus. But first, let's pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you for all of my friends who are watching this today. I pray that you would use them to show kindness to each other, that you would teach them, that they would know your love and your kindness, that you would change their lives in an amazing encounter that they could not help but share with everyone. We thank you for your gift of your son, Jesus, who died on the cross to save all of us from our sins. And in your name we pray, amen. Thank you for joining us today. I hope you learned something new, and I hope to see you next week. Bye.
Break of day, in hope we rise. We speak your name, we lift our eyes. Tune our hearts into your beat. Where we walk, there you'll be. With fire in our eyes, our lives alight. Your love untamed, it's blazing out. The streets will glow forever bright. Your glory's breaking through the night. You will never. We'll be right back.
Praise God for the living water that He gives us. Thank you for joining us today. Have a great week.